Imagine you are building a new house. You want it to be strong, modern, and easy to expand. But instead of using brick or mortar, you decided to use some new component. A component which is lighter, faster, and future ready. That's exactly what Lightning Web Component does for Salesforce. Today, we are going to see how this framework has changed the way we develop in Salesforce. So let's dive into and see why LWC is considered to be future of Salesforce development. So without wasting any time further, let's proceed with the video. Lightning Web Components is a modern JavaScript framework created by Salesforce to build reusable components within Salesforce platform. So basically, Lightning Web Components is nothing but a JavaScript framework created by Salesforce, and with the help of this, you can build components that can be reused across various applications in our Salesforce platform. Now, LWC leverages web standards and provides a fast, lightweight way to create components that can be reused across different parts of an application. So as I told you, the components built by LWC can be reused across the Salesforce platform. But the most important thing is it leverages the web standards. And because it is working according to the web standards, it is much faster than its predecessors. But the question arises, why LWC? So there are plenty of reasons for it. One of them is modern web standard. LWC is built on native browser API. You need not to depend on proprietary frameworks, and that makes it a modern standard framework. Because of this, the performance of LWC is much better. LWC is optimized for speed and efficiency, ensuring that your applications are much faster. And of course, the developer experience. LWC provides a more streamlined development experience with less boilerplate coding as you were doing in its predecessor known as Aura Components. Now, you don't forget to mention in the comment what exactly excites you about LWC. Now, LWC versus Aura. Now, if we talk about LWC, it uses modern web standards with custom elements and Shadow DOM. It is more lightweight and faster, and it is easier to learn for developers who are already familiar with JavaScript. If we talk about Aura components, it is older framework on the Salesforce platform. It is more complex with a very high learning curve. And of course, the most important thing is we can use LWC inside Aura, but Aura components cannot be used inside LWC. So these are the major key differences between LWC and Aura component. You should mention in the comment, have you ever used Aura component before? Mention there as hashtag Aura, yes or no. Now, what is the basic structure of an LWC? An LWC composed of HTML, JavaScript, CSS, and meta file. Now, meta file is nothing but an XML file which has the metadata description about our component. Now, HTML, you all know about it. It is a markup language basically to decide the user interface of the web page. JavaScript is used to decide the logic and behavior of the component, and CSS is used to style that component. This meta file actually defines where we can use this specific component in Salesforce. So we can restrict any specific component to be used or not to be used in Salesforce by specifying that in the meta file. Now, if you have already worked with HTML, CSS, JavaScript, believe me, you will feel it like you are at your home only. But don't worry, even if you haven't gone through the HTML, CSS, and JavaScript, we are currently running a crash course on HTML, CSS, JavaScript on our own YouTube channel itself. If you haven't watched that playlist, you can right now click on the I appearing on your screen and go to that playlist and go through it. If you already know about HTML, CSS, and JavaScript, feel free to continue from here ahead. Now, if we see an example of a simple LWC, it is composed of an HTML that you can see over here. Now, you might be wondering about few of the tags that is written like lightning layout item, template, C proper lookup or something like that. Now, because we are using HTML, the syntax of using it is exactly like HTML. Even all those tags that are available in HTML can be used over here. But instead of that, LWC also provides us with few of the custom tags, which is its own built-in components, and we can certainly use those tags as well. But remember, all these tags that are basically created by Salesforce can only be used in LWC. You cannot use it in a normal HTML, CSS and JavaScript. Other than the HTML, we also have a JavaScript. You can clearly see it is a modern JavaScript, as we are importing and exporting things. We are building a class, and here we are inheriting the characteristics of Lightning element. Now this Lightning element is what? You can consider it to be a class. So this Lightning element is nothing but a predefined class in LWC. And if you want your JavaScript class to behave like a Lightning web component, it should extend the Lightning element class. Now we will certainly go in depth of it when we will proceed ahead and when we will create our own LWC. But for now, you can just remember that in an LWC, you will create an HTML, you will create a JavaScript. Now these are the two mandatory files that should be there for each and every Lightning web components. CSS is optional. If you want to provide some extra styling, or I should say, if you want to provide some custom styling, then only you should use CSS. Otherwise, LWC use the default styling of Salesforce. Other than that, we also have a meta file, which is nothing but an XML file where we actually specify which specific API version we are using for this Lightning web component and whether this Lightning web component is visible on the Salesforce platform or not. The isExposed feature that is written over here is actually used to specify whether this component is available on our Salesforce platform or not. Now you don't forget to mention in the comment whether you are new to HTML, CSS and JavaScript or you have already worked on it. I would be waiting for it. Now let's see how to create an LWC. Certainly you have to follow some steps, but in this video we are just telling you about those steps. We are not focusing on how we will perform it. In the coming videos, I am definitely going to show you how you are going to perform these steps and create your first LWC. But let's see what we need to do. First of all, you need to configure your development environment. Now to configure your Salesforce development experience and Salesforce development environment, we will use Visual Studio Code. Now those who are following my videos with Apex, they know that we can use Developer Console for basically writing down the Apex class, triggers and whatnot. But Lightning web components cannot be created on our developer console. Even those who are coming from Aura background, they also know that we can create Aura components on developer console. But Lightning web components are quite special. So to create it, we are going to use Visual Studio Code and IDE. Definitely, not only that, you should have a Salesforce CLI command line interface, which should be installed on your system. And in our Visual Studio Code, we will install some extensions related to Salesforce that will make our Visual Studio Code capable to create Lightning web components and deploy it to our Salesforce org. Now, all these things, as I told you, I'm going to explain them, but certainly not in this video. So after you configure your system, after you maintain your system to work in the Salesforce development environment, the next step to do is create a new Lightning web component. Now, as I told you in the previous steps, we already have installed Salesforce CLI, Salesforce command line interface. So by giving some commands of this Salesforce CLI, we can certainly create our Lightning web component. Once that is created, we will write down our HTML, JavaScript, and if needed, CSS file. Also, we will mention whatsoever configuration is required for this LWC in the meta file. Now, this meta file not only contains the version and the detail whether it is exposed to Salesforce platform or not, it is also used to specify plenty of things. In our course, we are going to talk about all of them, but certainly not now. And of course, when all the development part is done, you have to deploy this to your Salesforce. Now in one of the video, I have already told you that how you can set up your Visual Studio Code for Apex development. If you haven't watched that video, you can certainly click on the I right now and go and watch that specific video. Second thing is, even if you don't want to, just relax. In the coming videos, I'm going to tell you again how you are going to perform it. So feel free, just understand the LWC for today. Meanwhile, don't forget to mention in the comment that have you already set up your development environment or not. So you can mention that hashtag dev environment, yes or no. Common use cases for LWC. Now, LWC is used to provide custom user interface. We can build rich interactive interfaces for Salesforce application. These components are reusable. So once you create them, it doesn't mean that it will be used over there only. You can reuse these components anywhere else with the same functionality if you need it over there. Lightning pages. You can certainly add LWC to Lightning app pages through Lightning App Builder, of course, to customize user experience. Now, you should mention in the comment, what do you think, what sort of components we are going to create in LWC? If anything is coming in your mind, don't forget to mention in the comment. Let it be right, let it be wrong, but share ideas and let this course be more interactive. Now, that marks the end of this video. See you soon in the next video. Till then, thank you and take care.